So much has been made of education and knowledge, and I think we need it on the public health side, we need it on the medical side, we need it for the public. The way the public will feel better is by knowing how much illness can be mild and what their personal risks are, as well as how to protect themselves. Those are obviously the factors that help to make people feel somewhat more reassured. And I think with respect to comments and others, I actually would say the same thing about my comment with seeking medical care, is we are all in this together. This is a global disease, this is a global outbreak. This affects all of us, and we are all one population, both in terms of our health and social distancing. We should be grateful for actions of the Chinese, the Italians, others who have delayed some of the spread to help us respond. And we should all recognize that we have a stake in responding effectively together, and that's true in our neighborhoods as well as in the country in our global perspective.
I think it will be important for people to keep remembering that this is a new coronavirus. By being new, it means that we are living in a world of uncertainty. And so we all have certain responsibility of making probabilistic assessment rather than thinking that someone will give them a deterministic reply. And I think that reality should just be given to the people, but also feel that managing public expectation and knowledge is very important to be done in a situation where the public and the government and the system is in a trusting relationship. And so being able to be transparent, being able to provide information in a way that we are working together, I think is very important.
Yeah. So I just want to in terms of adding that, we have just a couple minutes left, so I'm wondering if you could also pack that into kind of final notes and wrap up, and we'll kind of go through.
That is what I wanted to say for my final event. Anyway, so I think my take on quelling fear is really about what I wanted to leave people with. I think that the fear is a natural response that can lead us to do good things if it's channeled into self-protection rather than into harming others. And self-protective activities include all the hygiene measures that were mentioned earlier, includes getting up to date on vaccinations to prevent contact with the healthcare system. It includes, if you smoke, quitting smoking because you need your lung function, and that is important for this. It includes staying home from work to protect others if you're sick. It includes making that possible if you're a business owner. These are all individually self-improving acts that will reduce one's own risk. And this is a happy case where every one of those things also has benefits to the community. Slowing the epidemic is what we have to do if we can't stop it. And all of those measures, small though some of them may be, help to slow the epidemic. So there's a real coincidence, a real coalescence between individually self-protective measures and measures that will benefit the community. Mm-hmm. As long as they're those kinds of measures and not avoiding people you think are somehow more contagious or because of their race. I mean, that is not helpful to anyone, of course. But the basic hygiene and self-protection measures are in fact socially beneficial.
Hilary, I'd love to turn to you just for a couple quick wrap-up comments for the panel.
Sure. So it's hard to come right after all of those excellent comments. I agree with everything that has been said there. I would also come back to something that I said at the beginning, which is that when we talk about trusted sources and getting the word out there, you guys are at HSPH, right? You have access to all of the best information, and you can be some of the best communicators that we have out there. So I would really take it upon yourselves personally to help in this effort. I'm sure many of you already are, but I'm sure it would be much appreciated by everyone up on that panel. So thank you.